This is FabbLab, an innovation space where a team of young grand entrepreneurs and scientists and engineers are working around the clock to make sure that they produce a product that is currently needed across the whole world. And this is the face shield. The demand of face shields has been going up because of the fast spread of the new coronavirus pandemic. This is an example of the kind of the product that I'm making. It's a locally made face shield. And you can look at the way it's designed. Everything from the design is happening here to the assembly. This is done by a team of young runners.
FabbLab has been an innovation space for 4 years now. What we've been doing is that we have been working with entrepreneurs who have hardware ideas. So what we do is that we help them to make valuable products from their ideas. That means from ideation stage to prototype stage. As Rwandans, as the youth, when we are here in lab, what we focus is that we create our own jobs. That's what we do most of the time. But in this pandemic, we create jobs, but we also have to help the country to fight this pandemic. So we thought we have different projects that we can do to help the country, to help the citizens. And we thought of coming to face shields that will be helping these doctors who are really in risky, who are taking risk to help our people. So we had to come up with an idea of face shields, and we were doing another project called ventilators that are very cheap, but we thought to take longer, then we started making face shields. So they are now appreciated by the government and other people are using them. So that's how. It was our first time to work on any product related to medical stuff, and we managed to do it because of our global network, as I told you, and also because of the government, like Arabis has been helping us to give us feedbacks. Every time we make a sample, every time we make something, we could take them to RBC, to NFDA, to see what their feedback of doctors in Rwanda. So it wasn't really easy, but with their help, it became very easy. The knowledge behind was that we have to cover the face of the doctor as he's working, and make sure that there's no virus coming into someone.
So this room where what we do is we assemble, disinfect, and also package. Package works here. So what you see, we have we have this foam and this part, and also the elastic. These are the three things we join, plus this. So that's where we find that you get this spaceship. So after assembling it, so we have measurements, as there's been research for worldwide. We know the forehead, we know how big it is. And for this one, we have actual measurements that has been confirmed worldwide experts. So after assembly, this is the final product. So the medical expert or any other person who is going to be protected will just wear it like this. And
you will need to
so it is comfy. You see this mattress? It's for you to be comfy when you are wearing it.
Following the policy of Made in Rwanda, we would like to continue doing it because we get it, like they mostly get it from China, and our policy, like our government is always encouraging us to make our product locally, if possible. And even if not possible, we have to try. So we will keep making them for the country.
As you can see, it curves around the face and goes low enough to ensure that droplets won't enter into the mask. and this is the product that is currently needed. At least they're able to make 500 face shields per day.